So should you purchase an electric unicycle or should you purchase an electric scooter? Which one is the best solution? And why I think that also electric scooters are going to be the solution to bring the electric unicycles to the mainstream. If you want to know everything about this, stay tuned until the end of the video. Hi everyone, Marcus here from MedPack, and if you love EUCs, PEVs and everything that have an E of electricity, this is the place for you. And today we are going to put side by side an electric scooter and an electric unicycle, or at least what is the big advantage from one to the other. I believe that the electric scooters, they are going to be essential for making an electric unicycle mainstream, and you will understand why. Looking to the UK, at the moment they are testing out some rental electric scooters that I didn't agree at all. Why? I think that every PEV should be owned by someone that really ride for a long period of time and that respect the rules. Many times that I'm riding an electric unicycle, I see guys riding electric scooters with two persons on the electric scooter, or without a helmet, or without some gloves, or without some pads to protect their body. So they are exposing themselves to problems. When you see someone riding electric unicycle, you normally see with a helmet, with some wrist guard, they are always wearing something. And I think that happens because when you look to an electric scooter, it's so easy to just start it. And that's why is the PEV that is being used in this trial to see if people start riding them, in opposite to they use the car or they use taxis. So in that way it's better for the environment, but I believe that is not the best solution for the future, and I'll let you know why. When you have an electric scooter, you have two tires on the floor, and normally you have a tire with a dimension of 10 inches. When you go here, you go with 14 16 20 24 inches. So when bigger is the tire, more stable is the device and more grip you get it from the floor. A very good example of that in a previous video where I talk about the Gotway M10-3. I didn't really like it. I don't think that is the right wheel for me, but for someone that wants something very small, or for a kid, it really works because it's really torquey and the response is simply amazing. But the thing is, if you want the comfort, if you want the mileage, the same way that it happens with electric skateboards, and by the way, I've done another video where I talk about this, definitely become a problem, because you need to really spend your money in very expensive electric scooters. So when you are in the electric scooter, or if you ask to your wife or a friend to just try an electric scooter, they are going to say yes, and they are going to try for a couple of meters much faster than they will say, let me try an electric unicycle. Because when they see you jogging around on top of a wheel, they think that thing is really dangerous. But they don't understand that the electric unicycle become an extension of your body. And I've said that already previously, and I will continue to say, when you are in every single transport that you have, like a car, a bike, a motorbike, an electric skateboard, an electric scooter, you are on top of a device that you control with your hands. So that device is never really connected to your body. When you go to an electric unicycle, it feels your body. So if you contract your gluteums, it feels that you want to accelerate. If you get scared with something that is happening in front of you, your body reacts and you lean backwards, basically you will start to brake before you even thought to brake. The electric unicycle, I think, is a much more complete device than the electric scooter, but the electric scooter also comes with some benefits. So when you try to brake with an electric unicycle, for example, it's all related with your skills, technique and power of the motor. When you go to an electric scooter, you just press and you brake because you have physical brakes. But that brings a problem because it's another investment that you have to do to just repair and to get it better. When you go to inside the electric unicycle, is basically the wheel is rotating in one direction, and when you want to brake, the wheel changes the direction on the inside, making the wheel stop. So there is no physical brakes. So that's why also it's much easier to brake with an electric scooter than with an electric unicycle. If you want range, also you are going to have very heavy and big electric scooters compared to the electric unicycle, and that becomes not so good. But when we talk about price, and that is also very important to bring people inside the electric unicycle, is that it's much easier to start with an electric scooter than starting with an electric unicycle. Obviously, you have electric unicycles very cheap, old models that you can buy in second hand and stuff, but they are not safe, at least in my opinion. The electric unicycles, they was not really safe, and now you can definitely see a massive improvement in direction to the electric unicycle, and they'll continue, and it's simply amazing what is coming next with some wheels like the V12 that I can't really talk on this video, but you'll simply love it. But when you look to the the electric scooter, it's the same technology and with the same issues. When you have the tire and you curve, if you have something, a hole or something that the wheel is catch, you have the possibility that it just rotates like this, the electric scooter just bends in front and you just fly out of your electric scooter. When you are on the electric unicycle, that is just one tire, all connected to your body, is all on beneath you. You have the hole and it just continues. So it's much, much harder for you to have an accident with an electric unicycle than having with an electric scooter. But the electric scooter also have some other benefits. The other benefit is if you want to just bring some bags on top of it, so something really heavy, you can do with an electric scooter that with the electric unicycle, you just have to grab with your arms. And if you don't have a lot of experience, that can completely mess around with your balance on top of it. Another thing that I prefer, obviously, on the electric scooter that I don't like so much on the electric unicycle, because you have a handlebar, you can basically put there your phone with your GPS and see it. Another thing also that I prefer in electric unicycles than I prefer in electric scooters, and is the same when we talk about electric skateboards, is the size of the mudguards. Normally they are really short, so they get you all dirty, and normally with electric unicycles you are safe, you don't get so dirty. So also really cool when you have to use it in the winter. Obviously you can have much easier suspension on an electric scooter, even very, very cheap. If you want a suspension on an electric unicycle, is much more expensive. Also it's much, much easier for you to customize your electric scooter than customizing an electric unicycle, because you have the handlebar and all those stuff that you can put some extra lights. It's much, much harder to do in here. But also another benefit that you have with electric unicycle is majority of them, they have speakers, so you can hear some music, you can hear your GPS on it. And when you jump to the electric scooter, you can't do that. Electric unicycles are much more fun to ride. They are much more complete devices because they are so strange. People really avoid them. Electric scooters are simply amazing because they are bringing more and more people into it. They are going to be the first ones to be legislate and allowing people to ride with it. They are important to bring more roads dedicated to PEVs. I think that in London you should have roads just for PEVs to reduce the amount of pollution and to reduce the amount of traffic. Electric cars will not solve the issue in London because they are too big, and just the amount of batteries that you have to produce a car, an electric car, it's massive. With those batteries you could produce multiple electric unicycles or electric scooters, allowing people to move from point A to point B much, much easier. Another thing that also I want just to point it out that is much better in the electric unicycle than it is on the electric scooter is how compact it is. So if you need to go to the gym, you can put this inside the locker. With an electric scooter, you can't. And also when you go inside a shop, maybe with your electric scooter, it takes a while to go inside, and maybe they will not want you to go inside with your electric scooter. Here, I never had issues. I just open, I just stop in the door, I push the handle and I walk in. My name is Marco, this is Matt Peck. If you enjoyed this video, don't forget to subscribe to the channel, comment below, smash the thumbs up, do whatever you want, but always with a smile on your face, and I hope to see you in the next one.